Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can use Spline to create these 3D blobs in which we have a couple of objects spread around the distance and the objects in the back are blurred. So we will see how we can create the materials for this and the deformation for this. Then after that we will see how we can create the interactions when you hover your mouse to make something like this. Alright, let's begin. Okay, so I'm going to be using spheres to create the blobs. So let me just delete this object in here, and then I'm going to click here on a sphere, and then I'm going to click and drag to create my first sphere. So this is gonna be just like a very simple one. Then I'm going to press Command, and then I'm going to click and drag over the sphere to make a duplicate. And I'm going to make a bigger one in here. Make another one in here that is slightly bigger. And I want to make a couple of others. Maybe one in here, one around here. And I think it will be like one or two right there. Now that I have my spheres, I'm going to change my background color. So I already have this background color that I want to use, but it's basically a slightly bluish and gray color here. Now what I want is I want to start placing these spheres in distance. So I'm going to put this one right in the middle. Now that we have our spheres placed, by the way, I'm pressing Option R to reset my camera so I can see everything from the front. Another thing that I want to do at this point is I want to switch to perspective. There's a few things that we can change. The first thing is that I want this one here to be a little more visible. So I wanted to put it around here. And this one could be more like around here. So this is gonna be like this, I think. That should be fine. And I want these two to be closer and this one to be a little smaller, I think. Okay, what I want is to create a couple of materials. I want this one to be the main one. So that's gonna be somewhere around like an orange color. So let's put here orange. And for now, let's just change this color to be something like orange. Then I want something that is more like maybe like green, blue, but let's say green. And then we want another one that's gonna be white. And that should be good for now. All right, so for the orange ones, it's gonna be this one here. And I think the ones in the back, or maybe this one here. And then for the ones in the front in here, it's a combination between green. So this is gonna be slightly greenish. Say like this. We're gonna put this in here. And then for these other two, I want the white color. So I'm gonna just use white. So actually I want to make another copy around here, and this will be white as well. It's gonna be white. And I think this one in here could be green. So let's just use green there. For this one in here, actually, it's gonna be more like a glass. So I'm just going to select here glass. And for now, that's all that we will do. I want to start changing the lighting. So this is gonna be on overlay. So it looks a little better, perhaps a little more orange. And then also this one is gonna be on overlay. And we can reduce this shininess to be 5. And this color needs to be a little darker. So for this, we want to create an asset. This is gonna be glass. And now we want to have like a first nail. So I'm using overlay so this color blends better. And then we can change here like the opacity to be something like 50. Yeah, I think that's good enough. For the blurriness, we want this to be 100. It's gonna be 255. And this is gonna be 1.08. For the orange ones, I want to start adding a couple of things. Like the first thing is that we want the shininess to be 5 instead of 10. And then I want to start adding a depth to this. So depth is like a 3D gradient. Then I just want to move this a little bit to this side in here. And I also want to add another depth here. And this one is gonna be a little bit more to the top. But for now, I'm going to disable that one and I'm going to focus on this one. So for this, I want the color to be a little bluish. So that works. And then a little blue here. And then we can change the opacity. So we're getting this kind of like bouncing light. I'm also going to use the smooth here, so it's a better transition. So this color needs to be a little bit more orange. something like this. We'll see a little bit about this later. For now, I'm just trying to focus on something that works. And then for this other gradient here, what we can do is that we can use white as well. So it's gonna be white, and then the opacity needs to be something like this. So it's kind of looking similar to what we are aiming. So for this one, I also want to add a couple of depth layers. So we're going to move this one to the bottom part, and also another one here that we can put on the top part in here. For this one here, yeah, I think I want also like a slightly kind of like a purple color. And then we can change the opacity, something like that. And then for the top part, I think it's gonna be white as well. But let's see about that. Now, I do want another light in this scene. It's gonna be a point light. It's gonna be like around here. And it's not gonna have any shadows. And also it's gonna be slightly to the back in here. Yeah, more or less, that makes sense. And for the shadows, I want to enable soft shadows, and I want to move my directional light to here, and I want to increase the blurriness. So it feels a little more blurry. And finally, the white color right here. So let's use overlay in here. So yeah, we can use a 60% of transparency on the lighting. Let's see if that works. And we can use Fresnel here, like receiving all of this ambient light. It's gonna be around, I think 60%. So it feels less intense. And then we can change here a little bit though. Opacity here. And for this one, I think we also can use like a depth layer. It's gonna be a little different. So it's gonna be something like this, like a purple color maybe as well, something like that. And for this we can change. All right, so I want to use the white color in here as well. Maybe actually this one could be orange. Let's see. Yeah, I think that's a little better. Now this is not looking so good yet, but I want to work on the blur first. So I want to create this plane here. It's gonna be between these two, and this plane is going to have a glass layer. So I'm just going to have a glass layer here, and you can see immediately that it's adding like this extra dimension because it's blurring everything that is behind. And now let's start working a little bit on the actual lighting for this. So I feel like the lighting is not quite right. So for this, I want to add like a depth layer. And this depth layer is gonna be for the bottom part in here, similar to the other ones. And this is gonna be like a slightly bluish. So I'm just going to copy this color here, and then something like that. And then we need to have another one, but this is gonna be bright. So we just add brightness, and then we can put it like on the top part. So we use a smooth in here as well, and we also need to use smooth in here as well. So this one, the hat seems to be a little more like subtle. Now this, what we can do is that we can play with the color, so this is not so strange. And maybe the lighting here needs to be a little less, like 80%. Yeah, I think that's looking good, but let's just evaluate this coloring here. So maybe this could be a little more purple-ish instead, something like that. Same color here, so that blends better, I believe. Let me just block this rectangle, and let's call like blue-red glass. And let's just lock this object so it doesn't interfere with my selection. Perhaps we can switch this to be more like orange, and this one could be more like white. How can we add the distortion, right? So blobs are usually more like non-perfect shape. Usually to create the distortion, you can add like a displaced layer like this, and this already will give you the result. And this is probably the best way to do this. For this tutorial, I actually want to show you an alternative to this, which is using the sculpting tool, because with the sculpting tool, we have a little bit more control over the actual shape. So I'm just going to click here and smooth and edit, and now I'm going to press here in the sculpt tool. And so I just want to change the size a little bit, maybe even bigger. So the cool thing about the sculpting tool is that if you switch here to the grab and then you start like moving the shape, you can control the shape whatever the way you want. So I found this a little bit more interesting for this type of project here. So yeah, this one could be a little bit like this, like a or sort of like a triangular egg. And then we can do the same for this one here. We can try like playing around with the shape, and then the same for this one here. Actually, let's reduce intensity so we can sort of modify the shape in a better way. And then we just repeat the steps for all of the other shapes, right? So maybe this one could be a little more. Perhaps something that we can do is that we can add Fresnel to this layer in here. So let's have like a Fresnel layer here, and let's use an overlay, but let's put the Fresnel below the other. So this is gonna have like this little ring light in here. All right, so we can do the same with the green color here. We can have like a Fresnel layer, and then we can put it below this, and then we can use overlay. And yeah, it's just adding this little extra ring light in the edges. Oh yeah, so here I'm also missing something, which is I want to use a smooth, so this is gonna give like a better transition as well. And we also need to do the same for this, so let's use like a smooth transition and also a smooth transition here. I think we can also do the same trick with the white material, and then we can add another gradient here, and let's maybe just move this gradient a little bit to the top. It's gonna be something like this. Then we can use white in here. It's gonna be like this, and then transparency. Yeah, so now that we have our materials ready, something that I want to do is that I want to have like a little transition when I hover these objects with my mouse. So I'm just going to start with this one here, which is the main one, and I'm going to create another state. And in this state, I'm just going to change the scale of this to be 1.05, and then 1.05, and then 1.05. And then I can create a new event in here, and this is gonna be a hover event, mouse hover. And then here in the transition, I want to make sure that I'm changing to the state in here. And then I want to use a spring transition. And then I think that's it. And then if we go to the play mode, you hover, yeah, that's looking good. But maybe we can add like a little rotation. So maybe if you hover, it kind of rotates like this. So let's see how that feels. Oh yeah, that's a lot better. So we can do the same with the other objects, a new state. We increase the scale. Let me just copy and paste that. And then we can change the rotation a little bit. So maybe in this one it will be like this. And a new event in here in which we use hover. And then in here we use the spin. And if we go to the play mode, yeah. So we can repeat the same process with all of the other shapes. So all right, seems like it's working. All right, it seems like our scene is finally ready. A potential next step from here is to insert this into a website, for example. So if you want to learn how to do that, you can check out this other tutorial that we did. There you will learn how to insert a very similar scene to this into a website using Framer and embeds. So make sure that you check that tutorial if you want to do that. All right, I hope you like this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.